Most wooden gates end up sagging, dragging on the floor, or just looking crooked. In this video, I'll show you exactly how to build a gate that stays straight for years, with no sag, no drag. I already built three gates on my property, all using these same methods, and they've been holding up perfectly. Today, we'll build gate number four, and I'll show you step by step how I do it. I'll walk you through the frame, the diagonal brace, and the one trick that makes it work. After building the gate, I'll show you how I installed the pull latch system, and I'll even show you how I made a hidden latch for this gate that's basically invisible from the outside. By the end of the video, you'll know exactly how to build a gate that will last a very long time. So, first things first, you want to decide how your gate is going to open, because that tells you where the hinges will go. For me, I want it to swing this way, so the hinges are going on this post. Now, speaking of posts, they have to be solid. I'm using 4x4s and I set them 32 inches deep in concrete.
So right now I just need to make my frame about a half inch smaller than this opening.
The opening here measures 26 inches wide.
So we're gonna do 25 and a half.
Take a few different measurements.
If you're not sure, I'd actually recommend leaving a full inch of clearance. For example, on my other gates, I left a 1-inch gap because I used this style of latch. But for this gate, since it's a changing room and I want it more private, I'm keeping it tighter at just half an inch. For the height of the frame, I'm making it 64 inches, so it lines up perfectly with the top and the bottom rails of the fence. That way, the whole thing looks much cleaner. So now we're going to build the rectangular frame. I'm using 2x4s of pressure-treated pine. First, I need to cut everything to length, so I'm going to cut my two verticals at 64 inches and my two horizontals at 25 and a half inches. I'll be doing some half-lap joints, so I place my boards one on top of the other. I make sure that the frame is square, and I mark where I need to cut.
I marked X's where I need to take out material. Now what we need to do is we need to find the center so we can cut exactly the right side and the right piece. Take our circular saw, keep adjusting the blade down until we hit exactly where we want to hit, which is this line right here.
So once I'm happy with the blade depth, I start making all the cuts. I then come back with my hammer and break off all the rest. And as you can see, the results aren't as clean as I'd like, so I come back with my massive chisel and I try and clean it up a little more. I'm gonna do one more half lap joint with my circular saw, but then we'll try out my new miter saw. Technically speaking, you could use a hand saw for all of this. You could use hand tools, you could use corded tools. I buy all of my tools secondhand on Marketplace. I actually got a crazy deal on this one. I spent $150.
I believe this is gonna go a lot quicker. I don't even need to take a measurement. I'm just gonna go off of this right here. So I'm gonna put my blade down until it touches right there. And I'm gonna put this down here, which is my stopper. Oh, clearly I've never used it before. Okay, there we go. So now it'll stop.
At this point, I did notice another problem.
I think it's actually because of the pressure I put down it.
And that was whenever I pull back on the saw, it applies a bit more pressure than on the push. And so moving forward, I only pushed the saw forward and raised the blade on the pull back. And the result was incredible compared to the circular saw. So this is
probably the cleanest way you'll be able to get it. I think I'm just gonna go ahead and do every cut this method. Look how clean that edge is.
If you're wondering how long this took, I believe it took about 5 minutes per half lap joint, and I had 8 of them to do. 5 times 8 is 40 minutes, but it was a lot quicker than using the circular saw and chisel method.
All right, so that took a lot longer than I wanted to, but we're all done. Now I'm just gonna find the correct number for each, and we're gonna position them. We're gonna be putting epoxy inside. Right now, I just wanna place them, position them. That's literally perfect. I just wanted to verify that it was good.
So now that we know the frame fits inside of the opening, we could double check it for square.
I just checked it by going from that corner over there, the opposite corner, checking there, 68 3/4, and over here also 68 3/4. So I know the door is perfectly square. We're gonna add another screw in each, and then we're gonna lift it up. We're gonna add quick set epoxy. You know, instead of just having screws, epoxy is just kind of like a reassurance that it will not start moving or shifting. And then after that, we're gonna set up the diagonal.
I made sure to take off the piece of wood very gently just to make sure that I don't push something out of square. I then mixed some epoxy. Technically, you could use a, let's say, Tight Bond 3 that would be waterproof. I used this 5-minute epoxy for my other gates and it's worked well, so that's what I used again for this one. Now, if you're looking at this frame and thinking it's strong enough to be a gate, you'd be wrong. Half lap joints are probably overkill, and honestly, you could just use the metal brackets they sell online. But as you can see here, even with the brackets, the gates are still sagging. And that happens for one reason only. So let's talk about the diagonal brace.
Where does the diagonal brace go exactly? Like this, or like this, or like this, or like that? I still to this day see videos online that still don't show it the proper way. So let's try and answer that question. This is gonna be a quick lesson on how to brace a gate. So my favorite game is Hangman. And we all know that if you were to put the brace like this, where would it go? Nowhere. So you have to put your brace like this. This is your brace that's gonna hold up the little man here that we're hanging. This is a post, is going all the way down to the ground. So we could pretty much think of this as our hinge side, then our post is gonna come attached to our hinges. And then from the hinges, that's where our gate starts. This here would be a stronger diagonal brace because it's on the hinge and it's going even a bit further. So this brace here is gonna hold more weight than this one. Maybe he's really sad because he's being hung. If you wanna hold him up, your diagonal has to be at the lower hinge, all the way up to the top of your door corner. So if we move on to our example here with this gate, has the hinges on the right. Where would you put the diagonal on this door? You wanna make sure that the lower hinge goes all the way up. And so this is gonna hold this weight, and this is gonna be transferred right into this hinge because this post right here is holding all that weight. So if you do your diagonal brace correctly, you will be able to have a non-sagging gate. Okay, so now let's go back to our gate. All right, so now that we know how to brace our gate, this is gonna be the top, this is gonna be the hinge side, and I'm gonna place a hinge right about there. So I'm gonna go and position this like this, and I'm gonna put it right here. And I'm gonna put it a tiny bit here because I actually wanna bring in a screw all the way across. And because, don't forget, I did half lap joints. So my piece of wood actually comes out all the way here. This is why I'm gonna go and place it like this. And now the best way to do this really is to do it on the other way, like this. And then we'll be able to draw it out and not waste any wood. And so this is how I'm gonna screw it in. 4.5-inch screws, and I'm gonna drill them in like this. And for the top, I'm gonna screw them in like this. But technically speaking, this brace should hold the door up by itself without the need of fasteners because it's the wood that's doing all the work. Because of that, really, there's not much needed in terms of fasteners. I could technically put one there and one up there just to hold it in place. But it's not the fasteners that are gonna be doing the holding of the gate. It's very important to understand that. What better way to explain this than visually creating a miniature model of my gate? That's why I spent all day creating this just for you guys. As we mentioned, this is my diagonal brace. I'm gonna put it in here and I will set it right there. You could push on this, you could put some weight on this. Actually, take my wonderful hot sauce, Cholula. Not a single screw installed. Now, let's try flipping it the other way. The problem with this here is that you're relying 100% on the fasteners, the screws, whatever you use. So once that gives out, that's what happens. It's not the wood doing the work, it's all of the screws and the metal brackets you've installed. So this here is called compression. Currently the wood is in compression, and the other way, the wood is in tension. In tension, the best thing you could do is actually use something like metal cable. As you can see here, my metal cable is doing all of the work. Okay, so as you can see, it works. So if your gate is currently sagging and you're looking for a fix, this is probably your fix, the tension. They do sell cables that allow it to be in tension. So remember that when your wood is properly placed, you technically only need one or two screws just to hold it in place, because it's not the screws doing the work. What about if the gate was horizontally longer? This method still applies. I'm gonna put it in. If I let go, it should hold, right? That is correct. So even if I apply pressure, the post is sagging, the hinges are about to break, but I don't see the gate sagging. And if we put it the other way around, you'd better have really strong bolts holding that piece of wood, because that piece of wood is in tension. As soon as I let go, the whole gate fails. So hopefully this helped you understand it better. I know for some people, I mean, me included, once you see it, it clicks. So if you're like me, you learn visually, and that's why today's sponsor is Brilliant. Brilliant is a learning platform that helps you become a better thinker, a better problem solver, with thousands of visuals, interactive lessons in math, science, programming, and more. Instead of just watching lectures, you actually get to play with the concepts yourself. Kind of like how I just showed you with my miniature model. It's hands-on, it's intuitive, and it makes the learning stick. I've been using Brilliant to sharpen up my problem solving and critical thinking skills, and honestly, it feels a lot like my DIY projects. You learn best by doing. If you want to give it a try and learn for free on Brilliant, go to brilliant.org/MatteoStabio, scan the QR code on screen, or click on the link in the description. Brilliant's also giving our viewers 20% off an annual premium subscription, which gives you unlimited daily access to everything on Brilliant. Let's get back to the build. Okay, so I'm gonna start off by putting the top hinge. Another upgrade you can do is install longer screws. These ones are actually quite small for what it is.
Now let's talk about hinges. I forgot to film this, but I used a clamp and some shims to keep the gate in place while I installed it. This gate is a bit different from my other gates I've built because it's on a corner post, and the way it swings meant I had to use these side-mounted hinges instead of the exposed strap hinges I used on this gate. I think it's also important to point out, depending on your fence style, you might need to install a picket on the frame before hanging the gate. As you can see on this one, to keep everything flush with the rest of the fence meant that I had to put that picket on first, and you might run into the same situation. Here's a little idea for your fence project. I just finished my 12-volt lights around the yard, and they came out too good not to share with you guys. Here's a quick teaser. All right, now that I got that out of the way, let's move on to installing the latch.
I bought two of these little kits here for the fence gate latch. They're like spring loaded. So I'm gonna install one here and one here because I'm kind of sick of always having to open it like this. Overhand, you know, my short friends and Fiona can't reach it. Let's figure this out together. And I mean, obviously like everything else from China and on Amazon, no instructions. So I'm just gonna have to figure this out. We kind of want this little hole at the top of this to be, I believe, in line, probably right around there. I didn't think about this one. So this goes in here like this, and then you pass this cable through, and then you hook it in like this, and then we'll put the spring. I know that my kids are gonna be tall enough to reach for this, so at least they won't get trapped in here. This one will be a little bit different. I don't want to go straight back because this is access from the front yard. So I want to keep this as hidden as possible. And so I'm going to create a special little secret latch here that won't be visible. So I have to go like a 45 degree angle from here, pass it behind this half picket. And then we're going to have the pull string behind. Sneaky, sneaky door. Oh no, can't reach it. I made it through apparently. Oh no. I nailed it right there, pretty much at the fence picket. Oh yeah. Yeah, baby, let's go. Awesome. I think that's even more visible. The only thing now is I need to figure out a way maybe putting something here to hold this down, like that. I 3D printed this little thing, which is just a hole here and a hole there. It was actually meant to be for my drill. I 3D printed it last week, but it's gonna come in perfect for this application. I just need to install it like this. That's awesome. That is freaking awesome. Oh man, I wonder if Fiona's gonna be able to find that. Can you find it? How to open this gate? You have no idea how long I've been wanting to create an opening that was secret. And this is a lot better than I anticipated. I really didn't think I'd be able to make it completely invisible. So I guess we'll find out when Fiona and the kids come home, and I'm gonna say, try and find the opening. There it is. All right, let's move on to the next project. All right. Yeah. Isn't that cool? Papa was building Minecraft in real life.
But
inside it's easier.
Thank you so much for staying till the end. If you did, I'm assuming you liked the video, you learned a lot. Share this video with your uncle or your friend that has that sagging gate into their backyard. You'll probably like this video or this video. I'll see you in the next one. Peace!